Tempui, and I'm 14 years old.
My name is Josiah, and I'm 11 years old.
And I'm Nathaniel, and I'm 16 years old.
Before we go into our scriptures, I would like to open it up with a song sung by my brother Nathaniel.
Chapter 34, verses 1 and 2. Josiah was 8 years old when he began to reign. He reigned 31 years in Jerusalem, and he did what was right in the eyes of the Lord, and walked in the ways of David his father, and he did not turn aside to the right hand or to the left. What does this mean? It means you are never too young to be used by God. When you put your faith in God, you use to change the world.
Just as you are never too young to be used by God, you are never too young for God to expect excellence. How can you be excellent? By being a great example to others through your talk, how you live, your faith and obedience to your parents, your respect for, and love for God's people, your faith and your purity. God is not a God of mediocrity. He is a magnificent God. You were fearfully and wonderfully made by the Most High. He has blessed us with the best, therefore he expects nothing but our best. Verse 2 to 4, verse 10 and 11. Says, each of you should use whatever gift you have received to serve others as faithful stewards of God's grace in its various forms. If anyone speaks, they should do so with the grace. They should do so as one who speaks the very words of God. If anyone serves, they should do so with the strength God provides, so that in all things God is praised through Jesus Christ. Amen. To him be the glory and the power forever. Amen.
1 Peter chapter 5, verses 5 through 10. Likewise, you who are younger, be subject to the elders. Clothe yourselves, all of you, with humility towards one another, for God opposes the proud, but gives grace to the humble. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, so that at the proper time he may exalt you, casting all your anxieties onto him because he cares for you. Be sober-minded, be watchful. Your adversary, the devil, prowls around like a roaring lion, seeking for someone to devour. But you must resist him, stand firm in your faith, knowing that the same kinds of suffering are being experienced by your own brotherhood throughout the world. And after you have suffered a little while, the God of all grace, who has called you to his eternal glory in Christ, will himself restore, confirm, strengthen, and establish
you. Now you know you. There's no need to wait. God wants to use you now to pray over the sick, to share the gospel and lead people to salvation, to encourage and love people, to serve for those in need. God wants to use you now to change the world.
Amen.
Lord, hallelujah.